April is a month for new beginnings in Japan. All over the country, entrance ceremonies are held for everyone from kindergartners starting their first day of school to university graduates beginning their first job. Every April, nearly 1 million young people enter the workforce, suddenly transformed from students into adults. Many of them will work for the same company for the next 30 to 40 years, until they retire at age 60. They are Japan's salarymen, lifetime employees of the companies that hire them.
Hello, I'm Robert Christopher, and I'd like to welcome you to Anatomy of Japan, the Wellsprings of Economic Power. Lifetime employment remains the ideal for many Japanese salarymen. The security of a job for life helps instill a feeling of loyalty toward the company, and the employee is viewed as part of the corporate family. In fact, the Japanese word uchi can be used interchangeably to mean either a person's home or his workplace. Today, less than 35% of the Japanese workforce actually enjoys lifetime employment, and the system may someday disappear entirely. But the idea of joining one company and moving up the corporate ladder one step at a time remains a powerful force in Japanese business life.
The springtime of life is very short. It is like a precious jewel. Don't let it go to waste. When you are not sure if you can make it, assume that you will, and press forward.
Students in Japan study with the aim of joining one of Japan's good companies, and the competition is fierce. Some young people prepare by attending special cram schools and take as many as 100 practice exams, preparing for the real thing in April.
We are turning out a product, and that product is our students. There might be some inadequate items in the lot, and we have to improve them, turning them into first-rate products. That's our job here in the employment counseling section. And then we send these products out to the companies.
In Japan, which company you work for is as important as what kind of job you hold. Joining a company means becoming a part of a team, part of the corporate family. To the university graduate, choosing a company is just as important a decision as choosing a mate. Japanese companies hold annual hiring exams in order to evaluate the enormous number of graduates who come looking for work every year. A prospective employee's personality and character are given equal weight with his individual ability. Some companies even investigate their applicants' family backgrounds and personal conduct.
French is the language often spoken in many developing countries. Are you prepared to make a real effort to learn French?
Yes, if I'm hired. I will study hard between now and next April.
How would you describe your character?
Well, I'm diligent. I decided that I would ride my bicycle to school, rain or shine. And I did so every day without fail.
Is there anything else you would like to ask?
I suppose I would be going overseas.
Yes, you probably would go often.
All I can think about is overseas posting. At the very beginning, I would be apprehensive about going overseas.
For Japanese students, these exams represent the first step to becoming members of Japan's business establishment. Only one-third of Japan's workers join the larger companies that can maintain such a heavy commitment to their employees. Fujitsu is Japan's largest computer maker. This is a ceremony for those who manage to pass Fujitsu's stringent entrance requirements. Overall, Fujitsu employs 50,000 people, with an additional 50,000 working in subsidiary firms. This year, approximately 5,000 new employees have been hired.
How long do you want to be?
At the very least, I'd like to reach the position of section manager, but who knows?
I'll try my best. I'd like to rise as far as I can.
Takuma Yamamoto is the president of Fujitsu. In many ways, he is a product of lifetime employment, where seniority is the most important criteria in matters of promotion and salary. That system is now coming under fire at Fujitsu.
1,000
men can't all be managers. We have to make some kind of choice here.
Fujitsu has a great many employees between the ages of 20 and 30, and wages and promotions cannot continue to be granted automatically. Recently, Fujitsu introduced testing to help select future managers. The number 3 General Systems Department handles advanced technology, the field where competition with other computer firms is most intense. The general manager of the department is Yoshihiro Kosaka, who recommends candidates for the section manager test. Becoming section manager is the first step to moving up the corporate hierarchy. The number 3 General Systems Department has 215 employees. The department is divided into 4 sections, each with its own section head. There are 19 different managers. And this year, 29 department members are eligible for promotion to section manager. They are part of Japan's baby boom generation. For them, lifetime employment is no guarantee of an easy ride up the corporate ladder. Kosaka has recommended 12 people for the test. 3 are rejected by the personnel department on the basis of age. The company is trying to bring younger men into the ranks of management.
There was nothing I could do about it. The man was almost crying. It's tough on me, too. If it were just up to me, there would be no problem. But the personnel department has its own ideas. That may be what the selection process is all about.
You might not get a second chance, so do a good job. Do your best, not just for your own sake, but for those who are coming up the ladder after you.
Receiving the approval of the department head and the personnel office is only the first step in a lengthy process. Now the examination period begins. Each applicant is required to write 6 essays. 1 is due every 3 weeks. The subjects are management strategy, economics and trade, personnel management, finance and accounting, production management, and marketing. Uehara is one candidate for the section manager position. Last year, he failed the exam. 2 failures in a row excludes the candidate from consideration for 5 years. If he doesn't pass then, he is sent to a subsidiary company. Kanji Miyaura has taken over his child's desk. He is studying personnel management, which, according to company lore, is the most difficult of the 6 topics. Miyaura was trained as an engineer, and this is a completely new subject. 3 months have now passed since the testing period began. All this time, Miyaura has been working steadily on his papers. Today, he is turning in the last of them. Like everyone else taking the exam, he has written and rewritten each paper 10 or 15 times. Miyaura heads home after handing in his paper to Fujitsu's personnel department. He must get passing marks on at least 3 of the 6 papers. A score of less than C means failure, and 60% of the applicants must be failed. When grading reports requires specialized knowledge, outside experts are called in to evaluate them.
I can see that a great deal of effort has gone into these papers. It's rather frightening when I think that a man's future is being decided in the few minutes that it takes to read one.
The second phase of the test is drawing near. It's an oral presentation of an independently researched paper given to an audience of three senior executives. Candidates must speak on how the company should position itself in preparation for the 21st century. It is a nerve-wracking experience and is said to be the most difficult part of the test. Each candidate has already begun rehearsing his presentation. Tonight, all the managerial staff and the nine candidates from the number 3 General Systems Department have assembled in a conference room. Each presentation is reviewed in turn. It is a serious matter for everyone concerned, since failure reflects badly, not only on the candidate, but on his superiors and co-workers as well. Today, the rehearsal took 3 hours. At home, the entire family gets involved.
You don't sound natural at all. It sounds really stiff. Why are you talking like that?
Well, do you think it's better if I don't point while I'm...
The day of the presentation has arrived.
I will now present my basic research. The subject of my paper is the relationship between the price of basic commodities and the cost of power generation, and the effect of their relationship on company policy.
You know, after the computer centers are networked, you should make another draft of your paper.
Each department determines how many section head positions it needs to fill, and that number determines the passing score. This year, the passing score is 69.58. A score of 69.56 or lower means failure. The examination period is over. Careers hang in the balance as the final results are tabulated.
129 men passed this time.
I'll have the results announced in December.
In Japan, more and more middle-aged men, transferred by their company, are living apart from their families. Kozaburo Kimura's family lives in Sendai. 5 years ago, Mr. Kimura was assigned by his company to a post in Sapporo, 500 miles away. At the time, his son, a senior in high school, and his daughter in her last year of junior high were preparing for university and high school entrance exams. For their sake, he left the family behind. There are an estimated 200,000 Japanese men like Mr. Kimura who live apart from their families because of company transfers. Children's education and care for aging parents often preclude moving the rest of the family to where the father works. Many companies now provide residences for employees living away from home, or pay small allowances to compensate for the financial burden of maintaining two households. The emotional burden of living apart is hard on husbands.